My film is called To Rest in Peace, and it's set in Kuwait during the first Gulf War. It's about a man who sees two dead bodies that nobody's burying. Day in, day out, he passes by them and nobody's burying them. He tries to get them buried. And it's actually based on a true story. It's about my uncle. During the occupation, it was a really horrible time when Kuwait got to experience for a very brief amount of time what other countries unfortunately get to experience for, you know, years and years and years. It was the kind of time when, you know, young men would be arrested randomly. They'd show up back at their home with soldiers. They'd be all tortured. Their eyes would be gouged out. Things like that. So it was a really grisly, horrible time. And that's really what he was risking, is the loss of his life. We had to film most of it in California for mainly budget reasons, because this was done as a USC thesis film. And so we had to find places in California that kind of looked like Kuwait. And then me and the cinematographer, Sean Connery, were able to go to Kuwait. And so we had to find places in Kuwait that kind of look like California, so that the two of them combined makes it look like we filmed it in one place. It took months and months and months of location scouting. Everything with actors was filmed in California. So there were a lot of driving scenes, and we filmed them all in front of a green screen. And then when we went to Kuwait, we filmed Kuwait. Drive-bys and put them in the background. And then also there's a scene on a beach where you see the Kuwaiti skyline in the background, and that's the one scene where people are convinced you shot that in Kuwait, right? And I say, nope, that's Huntington Beach in California. And my visual effects artist put the Kuwaiti skyline in the background. So, we're very fortunate, because we really could not have done this film without visual effects, and Mike Ashton was brilliant. My film is really about somebody trying to find a little piece of human dignity, even at a time of war. I'm very interested in dramatizing that inner strength that people can find, that ordinary people can become heroes, you know? Because he's this ordinary guy that I always known all my life, and for him to rise to the occasion and risk his life to do this thing that was really a symbolic gesture for a sense of human dignity, that was something that really moved me, and I wanted to share that story.